No sex dungeon. I don't like this track much either because, hey, guess what? Every single series in this game has this track in it, almost. By a 2017 Randage? I don't know what a 2017 Randage is. Fuck. Don't pass. You fuck. You motherfucker. Oh my god. Oh, now I can't. You sons of bitches. Ah, you fucking assholes. Well, fuck you too. Even though it wasn't him that hit me, it was a Celine. This is not going good. Hey, guess what, guys? The engine's blown. Motherfucker. I've already been streaming for 44 minutes and I've not completed this. No, it's not time for a new car. It's time to fucking just fuck them and just go on easy mode because fuck them. Okay, let's try this again. One out of three races in Forza 4. That's this game, too. Hey, look, I'm in first already. Ugh! Attempt 3. If you're watching this on YouTube, you probably haven't seen everything that's happened during the stream. It's fucking shenanigans. I know of easy ways to fix issues. Like, literally, just literally. I just said literally. Literally in a fucking valid situation where I thought it and I was like, oh, let's say literally. This will work. I will win. And I won't have to do this race again. And I will never have to race on this track on this game again. Unless I decide to play the game again, which I probably will. Sometime in the future, because hey, I'm a person who likes to play old games. Okay, so I'm extremely far ahead. You can't buy a race car because S-Class. I mean, this is about the most race car you can get. What about LP here? I mean, this isn't gonna be in the video. Well, I mean, this is probably because I'm probably going to win this because they're already fucking like 30 seconds behind. But the past two races are not going to be. Well, I mean, I might do highlights of when I got dicked, but that's about it. 2015 Ranger in England. Hey, we haven't had Rangers here since 2012. Or 2000. I think it's either 2010 or 2012. I can't remember which year they actually stopped bringing the Ranger over. And before I fuck up and I actually have time to fix my car. Because I literally can't pit if I get wrecked. Like, if I pit, then I'm just done. If I pit more than once, I'm done. Unless I run out of gas, then that's the only way this can get fucked. If I run out of gas. They're bringing them back. That's interesting. I think I've heard something about that. I don't know. I can't remember. I mean, as long as they look good, then yeah. Why not? Yeah, I'm gonna do something real quick. I'm gonna relax and just kind of sit back. There we go. I did not fuck up again. Yet. In this race. I probably will eventually. Well, I know I'll run off the track eventually because... Yeah, because I run off the track on every track with every car in every series of every game. So I probably will eventually, just not... I won't get dicked like I did in the last race. Because, hey, Lamau, mid-engine car. Bringing the Ranger back 2018. Huh. The 2000s model Rangers models... 2000s. Whatever the fuck. The Rangers from like 2000 to 2000 whatever, they stopped making them for the U.S. Are literally my truck, but slightly updated. And different engines, I think. I don't know. They might have still used the 2.5 liter. I'm not talking about penis, though. When did I talk about penis? I'm literally confused. Literally. Fucking literally. I like my penis. Just gotta be that guy. He's a solid guy. Is your penis solid? Like Dan Harnitz? Did I say dick? I don't know. Oh, I keep getting dicked. Okay, I see. I don't even realize I say these things until, yeah. Yes, I am very big confused. Also, I like that I can actually sit back in my chair. See, I ran off the track. I knew it was going to happen. My daughter is not named Dan Arnitz. But I like the fact that I can, like, lean back in my chair and still have my microphone super close to my face. Well, actually, I can move it closer. There we go. I can still have my microphone super close to my face, and if I want to lean forward, I can still have it super close to my face. So no matter where I go, I can keep my microphone near me. I got things touching me on the side of the face. I think it's hair. Come fill grass, goddammit. You know, there's actually a Kappa emote now. If you just type Kappa, like Twitch's Kappa, there's actually an emote for it. Believe it or not. So you don't have to do hashtag cap anymore. Even though it's a stupid emote, but you can still do it. And everybody's starting to recognize that Kappa is a thing. Yeah, you see? God damn it. This chat is getting out of hand even more and more. The lawn of your front lawn. So your lawn has a lawn. That is a lawn. Wait, yeah. No, I don't know what I'm trying to say. Okay, so the AI are way the fuck in the middle of buttfuck Egypt. Which is very good for test drive man person. It's an on college campus. Because college kids, and drunk, and things. I like how there's two separate Kappas. It's... what? Hold on. I want to actually do something because I can barely see shit from back here. Hey! Oh wait, I was going to say it doesn't work, but it does. Oops. There we go. Now I can actually see the chat while leaning back because I just zoomed in on Google Chrome. The regular Kappa and the racist Kappa. Why does there need to be two of them? Are they trying to make everybody happy or something? Are they trying to make SJWs happy? Because Twitch Kappa is extremely white? Now the chat is getting extremely out of hand. Hey, look at the AIs. They're like way over there. Way off in the middle of Buffek Egypt, not running into me and destroying my engine. Caring for the shrubbery, and it's usually white guys. The shrubbery? Yes, I know Rhino. I've been in your chat for how long yet now? Probably at least, I don't know, actually. When did I start watching your videos and streams and stuff, Rhino? I think it was whenever you were doing the career mode for Assetto Corsa, or no, you were doing Assetto Corsa. I remember you, I think my first stream that I watched, or first stream of yours that I watched, there we go, was you playing Assetto Corsa with a controller. And that's all I remember. When did you play Assetto Corsa with a controller? And that was probably about when I started. Well, I don't know. I may have started watching your videos before then. I can't remember. I honestly have no clue. They mow the grass and call it a day. Hesk antics. Ruining online racing? Was there actually somebody that said that? I mean, I can understand after that one guy came into my Assetto Corsa stream was like, "I bet you don't even know how to drive a real car, blah 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 blah. You can't drive a race car in a game, so you can't drive in real life, blah 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 blah. Stupidity." Because that guy. So this race is going well. Hugo, was that his name? Some salty showed to your Ask Core stream and said that. Oh my god. You weren't even playing online, probably, were you? Because you're not the person that plays online. Because yay, single player. Just like me, kind of. Although I do play things. I'm gonna see. I'm there. 25%. Hugo was YouTube retard? Okay. I mean, there's a lot of those, though. And apparently Jordan's back. I've played Assetto Corsa online, like, when the online first came out, and that was about it. Hello, Rumich. Welcome to the stream. Yeah, I very rarely play games online. If I do, it's probably Rocket League. And that's it. Because there's no way you can fuck that up, really, unless you have dipshits for teammates, which has happened. Online racing sometimes ends well. Like, I've had extremely good races on Forza 3. Yes, I see that you're new. I da. Don't need to post it twice. I'm feeling no more Google Plus. I don't know if he is even. Casual online racing. Tag on Forza 4, which is why I've probably mostly played online ever. Yes, we understand you are new. If you keep spamming that, I'm gonna time you out myself if Rhino doesn't do it first. Now you're old. Yes, Rhino, you know what to do. You have the power. Which apparently YouTube has timeouts now, which is neat. Neato. 25 laps because endurance race. The Rhino doesn't do it first, as I kind of figured. Streaming at 120 with a Cobra. That sounds like me playing Forza 4 Tag, because I got so good at playing at avoiding people in Tag with various cars. Like, I've used the stupidest cars in Tag on Forza and have won. But yeah, like, I've gotten so good at juking people, it's so fucking funny. Because people are so predictable online. Yes, endurance race. Because yay, I have to play through everything. Even though 25 laps still doesn't really feel like an actual endurance race. which is why I should play through more of GT5 and get to the endurance races on it, so I can do wheel thing. Casuals dive bomb hairpins. Yes, exactly. I mean, nobody knows how to use brakes on online. Brakes do not exist online on any game, no matter if it's Assetto Corsa, or if it's Forza, or if it's Gran Turismo, or if it's Forza Horizon whatever. Forza 5? I never actually played Forza 5 Tag. I don't think. Maybe I don't think I have. Actually, I think I did once or twice. But yeah, Forza 4 Tag got really, really fun because I knew how to fucking juke people so much. I've played a little bit of Forza Horizon Online, Forza Horizon 2. Horizon 1 I never did until, like, I did an open lobby on Forza Horizon 1, like, a long time ago. And that's it. That's all I've played of Horizon 1. I don't dank. Did I say that? I don't think I said that. But I actually... I found out that... I think it was D-Class. Or no, it was E-Class, maybe. The Peugeot 206... completely stock in Forza 3, I was able to win a race with, which was pretty awesome. Horizon 1 Online was excellent. I've heard that, but I never actually, like, cared enough to play it a lot. Like I said, until I did that open lobby, and that was it. That's still the only time I've ever played it. Because I wanted achievements, but I only managed to get, like, level 4 or something. I just want to play original Xbox games online with friendos. That's like my main goal of YouTube. Well, maybe. I don't know. I mean, considering I could find people that would play games with me and stuff. Trackmania is fun online because you can't hit a... nobody can hit you and screw you up. Which makes it actually good. I mean, it's not incredibly exciting because it's literally just single player, but with more people running at the same time that aren't hitting each other. Only played it for the 250 GTO. Make money from a job and fine play games. I know, right? That was me before I got a job. And then I got one and I was actually able to, like, buy games and it made me happy. Although I haven't bought many games besides Forza 6. I've bought Rocket League. I think it's just been Rocket League and Forza 6 have been the only games I've bought since I got a job. Everything else, all my other money has went towards insurance, gas, microphone stand, HDMI splitter, PlayStation. I did buy a PlayStation 3 and a bunch of games. Well, 5 games for it. So I guess that does count. Wanna work at Rooster Teeth? Have no skill to Motor Erotica. I didn't have any skill. Like, oh wow, I'm about to laugh, people. Like, every day is a learning experience at Moto Exotica. You get to drive something new every day. And you have to learn how to drive that new thing every day. And it's actually not incredibly easy. They need a new minority. I mean, you know, if you want to move down to Missouri, go ahead. I mean, I can drive car, but if everything is different, then it doesn't make any difference. Because you always learn something about certain cars, like where the clutch hits, how you shift it. Like, I drove a Porsche 914 today that did not have... it was missing 3 gears. I had first gear, third gear, and reverse out of 5 gears and reverse. Present one. Sunk through the floor? Jesus Christ. Why is there an Enzo in last? Who is Enzo, man? Hold on. M. Weber. Bruh. Pyraptor. I actually watched Ray various... random times on his stream that he does. Even though I never, like, watched any kind of Rooster Teeth anything. Oh, okay. You must... Okay. But, I never really watched Rooster Teeth. I tried to watch some of their videos, and I didn't really like them. But I actually have watched Ray a couple times on his stream, and it's not bad. I like him. Besides the fact he doesn't stream at 60 FPS, but blah, 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 blah. That doesn't really matter that much. So yeah, there's my story. There's my background of knowing Rooster Teeth. Ray is a cool guy. I think I watched him play Borderlands 2 once. Or some Borderlands game. I don't... Greatest video ever for Far Cry. I still need to play through Far Cry 1, 2, 3, Blood Dragon. Well, I've played through most of Blood Dragon. I never watched her Minecraft stuff. Okay, there's something really uncomfortable underneath my ass. Because, yeah, there's things underneath my ass, so I'm gonna fix that real quick. BRB. Well, not really BRB, because I'm just gonna put my controller down somewhere where I can find a place to put it down. And then stand up. Eh. He gets attacked by a dog. Jesus Christ. Sorry if you heard that. Oh, you probably did. Okay, so I'm gonna scoot in, grab my controller. Okay, so microphone. Hello, microphone. Okay, let's continue. Why are you just saying random words for sexual things? I'm so far ahead of the AI, but I don't care. Oh god. It's only lap 11, so I'm gonna wait a few laps longer to pit. You are sex? You are sex in human form. Go! Say it. Okay, go on the inside. I was gonna go on the outside until they took the outside fucking... Pfft, you got what you deserved, you asshole. I am the table. They were not... They were under my ass, not in my ass. I mean, I... Yeah, about that. Light. Celine did get wrecked, but I kind of slightly got wrecked in the process, which makes me kind of sad. I am the John Cena! Are you really the John Cena, though? So yeah, apparently I learned on Twitter yesterday because of so many people replying to me, replying to somebody else who has a lot of followers on Twitter about how apparently YouTube works thing. Way to bully on easy mode. Yeah, 45 minute race. They've all been 45 minutes. This isn't long for an endurance race. Like, you know Gran Turismo 5 has 24 hour races. Even though you can pause, of course, and yeah. 45 minutes isn't that long. I've raced just kind of dicking around for like probably 3 hours before on various Forza games. John Cena's high school dating sim? What? John Cena's sexy high school adventure? What? Why does this exist? Oh hey, it's a car that was actually completely just owning me before. I get wrecked, nerd. TB and Genna Jenna. I don't know who those people are. Come here, Mr. McLaren, man. I want to lap you. I want to lap you. Oh boy, so Nürburgring endurance next episode, which is pretty awesome. Damn it, bastard. Screwed up my shit. Only problem I have with this kind of setup. Oh, Total Biscuit. Yeah, okay. PC guy can be occasionally funny. Okay. Yeah, I know he does, like, videos on, like, PC games and various reviews and... I don't know if they're reviews or if they're, like, first look things. I remember watching his Need for Speed Rivals video and he was ranting about the fact that it was locked at 30 FPS on PC. I remember that now. Game is stupid funny. Interesting. Also, rip everybody. I've lapped everybody. Steven plays. I don't know who any of these people are. Like, that's such a generic name, Steven. Like, what? Oh, balls. Okay, I'm good. I watched the Suzuka Rhino GT4. What a loser. Kappa. Okay. Stupid great dating sims. These lyrics to a Linkin Park song. Okay, I'm probably gonna pit at the end of this lap, just because. Because I can. Oh god. Hello, it's not Test Drive 426 live on here. God. Learn to know you're live versus not live. Very similar. I see the joke, but still. It took me a second. But I don't do the twitchy things anymore. Well, I kind of do very randomly, but at the moment, Twitch is just bleh. Learn the internet. Okay, I've never actually went in the pits on this track, I don't think. Time to figure out where the hell they are. Okay, let's see, where are the pits? I think they're just off to the right, yeah. Okay, I know where I'm going. Also, car behind is 2 minutes and 13 seconds behind. Let's enter the pits at like 20,000 miles per hour. Because there's no penalty on this game for doing so. Next to the control line. That feeling when these blisters from me burning my hand from trying to take the battery terminal, or actually tying up a battery terminal on a car, are about to fall off, which is meh. Goodbye, Mr. Mercedes CLK GTR, man. I have gas and tires now. 10 laps to go. Well, 11. Well, 10. No, 11. I am very confused. Honey Pop is GTY. I don't know. Forza 6 is as good as I think it's going to be, which I think it... I'm pretty sure after playing the demo, it's going to be pretty damn good. I think it might be my GTOY. Okay. Honey Pop is GOAT. Welcome back, Elijah. Hi, I'm Test Drive. I'm a single guy looking for single girls. Oh, the single ladies. I'm just sucking at making turns. Okay, let's try and actually play this game without running off the track, shall we? Okay. 4,800 meters behind. No. It would always win. Forza 5 wouldn't have won, in my opinion. Forza 5 wouldn't have won anything. Otherworldly women. It's a very interesting way to put it. I don't know why I feel I should, like, repeat everything that's said in the chat. Fuck. My dingleberries. So rip the front of the car. Nikki is the best. I don't even know who Nikki is. Well, Nikki makes me think of Nikki from Need for Speed Carbon. I did it. I did do it. I mean, I'm still gonna win by a buttload of time, but yeah, I did it. I mean, I said I was gonna do it. I even called it. So get on my level, scrub. Also, the car now pulls to the right because the left front brake is messed up. So yeah, that's fun. Super happy fun. I should actually stop looking at the chat so much. Maybe I'd actually, like, stay on the track then. Not crashing is not as easy as it seems. Especially when you're me. Because crashing is fun. Alien woman and horns. I don't know if I even want to, like, look up videos on this. Hey, I'm catching up to Mr. Mercedes, man. Again. I like how the entire chat is dead besides two people. Rip. And pepperonis. Please come back, Mr. Mercedes, man. Bugatti VGT before Bugatti GVG. GVGVGVGVGV. I am a great person at speaking. Still. Nobody will ever take my crown of speaking. I don't want Test Drive Plays Honey Pop. I don't think that would be a good idea. Hello, Mr. Mercedes, man. I'm going to pass you on the outside. Unless you wreck me, which you almost did. This was the most awkward person play the most awkward game ever. And before Rhino plays it. Am I right? Also, my car seems to be sliding a lot now, and I'm not sure why. 78 T-top Corvette. I drove a 68 Corvette convertible the other day. And as I was driving it, the battery cable's disconnected. Okay. 7 or 78. Nope. Hello, Mr. Mercedes Man, I need to pass you. Those nudity claims, oh god. The lurk is real with Rhino. Excuse me, sir, I'm coming through, thank you. Oh god. It's a strife place, honey. I can't stop fucking up. It's in my blood. I can't help it. Metropolis Street Racer. Did you actually buy it? For the Dreamcast? Because I'd have to buy a Dreamcast if I wanted to play it. Sure, it didn't happen. Hateful Boyfriend? That name sounds... Emily Later Hype? Oh, okay. That name sounds familiar. Can't say I've ever seen any videos of it. Never played it. Sega Meme Cast. The caster of memes. Hello, Adriana. Welcome to the stream. Pigeon dating sim? What? Oh, I think I have heard of that. Now that you say that, it almost sounds familiar. Oh, hello, Mr. McLaren. Oh, balls. I'm good. Hello, sir. Can you not? Thank you. I mean, he did still, but just can you not? What place is Selena Sevens in now? Oh, he's in third. He's not doing too bad. But hey, that's the first time I've lapped him. Well, it's the one I'm very confused on words. Neck is stiff. I hear my parents yelling at things upstairs. I'm pretty sure it's a TV. Because my dad especially likes to yell at the TV. They're strangely awesome. I don't know. I don't think I would be a good person of playing a dating sim game. This is a Seat Cupra GT concept prototype thing. It has a big Xbox symbol on it. A not Bugatti. Exactly. This is Xbox 360. Every time you drift in this game, it says way hey. Oh my god, that's awesome. Lol, Sega. My windshield is extremely broken, and it kind of makes me sad, although I don't have any use for it. Cupra is Spanish for coupe? I don't know. I mean, the Seat, there's a Leon Cupra, which is definitely not a coupe. So I don't think so. No, that's just a Leon. The Cupra, I think, is just like a special version of normal cars, and then they're like, oh, let's make it this thing. And it's like the Chevy SS, which is a car, but many cars have worn the SS badge that aren't just the SS. Yes, this is Cupra GT. Whatever that means. Oh, God. Okay. I scratched back my neck. Yes, the big not-so-fast thing. I mean, it's fast. It's just not great for this track because, hey, long straightaways. Also, I'm off the track. I am so good. Also, six to go hype. Hello, Razor Synapse. Go away, please. Oh, my Jesus. Okay. I can't help it. I don't know if it's like that, because Callaway is like their own company. This is definitely not a Leon Cupra. This is just the Cupra. Mother Ducker. See, it's AMG GT. It does have a really silly name. And it's not even the Mercedes-Benz. It's just a Mercedes-AMG instead of Mercedes-Benz. It's like, what are you doing, Mercedes? You're supposed to have Benz and everything. Motherfucker. Turning. Oh, turn too early. Okay, never mind. I am good. Also, I am exactly 8 seconds behind. If I didn't have a penalty. Ben's deaded. Rip Ben's. They broke up. Mother father. You mother father! How does that... I don't think it works like that. Also, scratching the back of my leg. Oh, that feels great. Okay. Ugh, it's love you saw. Drifting! Mother bother Caitlyn Jenner, oh my god. I'm not sure how to respond to all of the commotion. Also, I'm nearly 3 minutes ahead now. Which is pretty awesome. I know it all too well. Okay. The chat, of course, is doing well as usual. Anytime there's meme heads in the chat is doing well. Also, I'm about to lap somebody for the second time. I saw them up there. I don't know where they went. There they are. Oh, nope. There they are. Enjoy being dead horses. What would be awesome? Overkill is yummy. Hey, I thought that was a good number, but it wasn't. Fiat 500 with a 6.3 V8. I don't think that would work. I think that engine is as big as the entire car of the Fiat 500. I think you'd have to put the engine in the back. Which, oddly enough, is... We had a car at Moto Exotica that I never saw. It was before I started working there. It was a Fiat 500. Like a whatever, 60s, whatever. Early 60s. That had an RX-7 FB rotary engine with a turbo on it. And apparently it was really fucking fast. It was in the back of the car. I don't know if I said that, but it was. motorcycle engine in the back of a tricycle bike? Or trike bicycle? Wouldn't that be a tricycle? Are you trying to kill children by putting motorcycle engines on their cars? I mean, nothing's as good as the one trike that's like a motorcycle trike that we have in Moto Exotica that has a small block Chevy V8 in it. It has a 350 Chevy V8 in it. Put a motorcycle engine in a car. Oh, wait. Mules and super boxers. I think it was pretty terrifying, honestly. Adult trikes? Since when do they make adult trikes? What? I've never heard of such a thing. I know of bicycles, and that's it. Three to go. On the third attempt, so. That would be a tricycle. And I've never heard of an adult-sized tricycle before. Bring a Superbox engine in Porsche. Wait. Except for those are six cylinders in Porsches, not four cylinders like in Watchmen Doodles. Yeah, the Dodge thing, what's it called? I can't remember what that thing was called, the Dodge Maiden. Oh, it's it's called the Tomahawk? Never mind. 2.0 Jaguar. Motor Trikes. Escort you grew up with had a Chevy engine. Speaking of Porsches, I actually drove two Porsches today. And you never realize how much it makes a difference in sound of the car between having the engine in the front and then having the engine in the middle or the very back. Like there have been Porsches that have had. There's a huge difference. You're like, whoa, this is weird because you don't hear anything in front of you anymore. It's all behind you. Like you hear nothing in front of you besides wind. Because I drove both a rear-engine Porsche and a mid-engine Porsche today. BMW 8 Series. Like an old 8 Series, like the 845, 850, whatever. Those are pretty cool. I still want a Mercedes wagon, diesel. That's what I'm looking forward to. That I should definitely save my money for. I'm gonna save all my YouTube money for it. Says a guy who gets shit for money per month. Fuck the tailpipe. We don't have Cortinas, so I don't know what a Cortina is. Well, I don't know what a newer Cortina is. With a V6. We had a Cortina at Moto Exotica that was sold before I got there. Put something cool in the engine hole. Like your dick. Oh! I mean, I don't know why I went, oh, but, oh! But I think escorts are mostly the same. Between the European ones and the American ones, although they look different. Like, the European ones look so much better than the American ones. And the American ones had the engine and transmission on my truck. Basis for the Capri. We don't have Capris either. Last time we had a Capri in the United States was like 1992. I am good joke man. Also nearly one to go hype. Until we only have five, I think, things left. Which I think I'm going to do two tomorrow, maybe, or two on Sunday. Escort America is smaller than a Taurus. Like, a lot smaller. Hey! Yeah, we had Mercury Caprice in the 90s too, in like 19, I think 1992 or 3 was the last year for it. Was like it was it looked like a Buick Riata, but it was a Mercury Capri. But they had Ford Capris. Yeah, it was the precursor to the Focus, the Escort. Like, it went Escort, then Focus. My dream car is probably a Charger SRT Hellcat. Because the Ford Focus came out and replaced the Escort. That's why there's no more Escorts. Well, there wasn't any actually, there was Escorts during the Focus times. No, I know what you're talking about, but there was a Mercury Capri in the late 80s and early 90s that looked like a Buick Riata. I think the Mondeo is a Ford Fusion. I think I know that much. It's not a meme answer. It's actually what I want, because it was the Dodge, it was the Charger SRT from 2012 to 2014 until I actually started liking the newer ones, so now it's a Hellcat. So yeah. Hickmerkin. Oh, Jesus. But yeah, we actually didn't, now that I think about it, the Escort was a smaller Focus back in the early 2000s. We had Escorts until 2004, I think. But then we also had the Contour, which was like the same thing, but not really. Yeah, the ZX2s was one I'm thinking of. I thought for some reason that, like, the Escort stopped and then the Focus start, but it... Hey, I just realized I finished the race. Dodge... Is that a meme? What? Q, are you meme head man? Yeah, I'm not a big supercar person. Never really driven them besides... Well, never... The closest to a supercar I've driven is a Ferrari 308 from the 80s. I see some weird-ass four-door things. I mean, they are cool. The Charger, the new Chargers. They look cool. Like, I don't care if they're a sedan. I can carry more friends that way. Yeah. I got things. Yeah. And then there has to be a Ford Australia, too, because, hey, Falcons. I mean, everybody has different tastes, man. You can have whatever you want as your meme car. Also, I got a thing. It's a Maserati thing. Austin Allegro? I don't know. Charger sedan is a Charger, though. Wait. Okay, we don't have the Porsche race next. It's the R4 race next. Let's check out my thingy-majigger. 94%. Still 1% behind my current thing. Total winnings, 9.4 million credits. Also, I have 174,000 credits to play with. Anyways, if you guys are watching this on YouTube, I'm going to stop here. If you're watching the stream... Yeah, memes. So, yeah... Thank you for watching the video, and I'm gonna stream for a little bit longer.